Welcome to today's show, which is about the Red Sneaker Writers podcast. It's where I talk life stories with a New York Times best-selling author. The show today is brought to you thanks to the Structure Success video training, which helps you come up with a rough outline of your life story. I'll have more details about this free gift at the end of the show. If you're brand new to Forever Young Autobiographies, a big hello. It's where we learn to write life stories for family and friends so unique memories can live on. Be awesome if you could follow, subscribe, and like the show. So it was my great pleasure to be a guest on the Red Sneaker Writers podcast recently. It's a popular show that features writing news, but also interviews with authors, with agents, with editors, and other writing professionals. Now, it's hosted by the New York Times bestselling author William Bernhardt. He has written over 50 books, most recently a thriller titled Exposed. Now, it was fantastic to talk to William, and we talked about many things, and I'm going to give you a bit of a highlight about some key questions in today's show. So the first one we kicked off with was, what's your number one tip for writers? And my answer was to set a deadline. Now, if you're sitting down to do a writing session, you can set a deadline with a timer. It can be an old-fashioned egg timer, or it could be a timer on your mobile phone. Another way to set a deadline is to set a deadline for a project, or it's a part of your project. So you can put a date on the calendar. It might be that you want to finish a chapter, or maybe you want to finish some edits. Having that date on the calendar is really going to help. Now, as a print newspaper journalist, I know firsthand how deadlines can really help. I've seen it time and time and again. It really does help you focus your mind and get more writing done. So give it a try. Set yourself a deadline. Another question William had for me was, how do you start a life story? What's some tips to get off to a great start? Now, my suggestion was just to pause before you start writing anything. Get some things straight in your head with a little bit of planning. So you might like to think about, what's your format going to be for your life story project? Who are you writing for and why? You're also going to want to get some memories coming to the surface and figure out probably a rough chapter outline so you have something to work with. And remember to cultivate a positive mindset towards your writing, because we do all have that internal critic, and it's important that we don't talk ourselves out of it. Don't talk ourselves out of writing. You can also do some practical things, like tell some loved ones who are supportive, and they're going to be a bit of an accountability for you to keep you writing, check in on you, make sure you're making some progress. And you can set up a writing space for you, so somewhere that everything is there, ready to go, and you can sit down and get more done. So there were some ideas around pausing before you start writing and to get the planning done so that you'll then be able to write, edit, and publish a life story project. Now, the last question I wanted to talk about was, what William asked me was, are you a planner or are you a pantster? Now, a pantster, you may be asked, what is that? It's someone who is the opposite, who does the opposite of planning a rough chapter outline. It's someone, by that quote or that saying, flies by the seat of their pants. They just fly into their writing. They just see where it ends up. And this can work for some people. Like, that's fine. But I think I'm definitely a planner. I'll put my hand up for that one. I prefer a rough outline to no outline. I think it really helps combat writer's block, because you know what you're going to write next, or you know some ideas to write next. And it's a bit of an insurance policy, because you're tackling the key memories, the key events, and getting those down in case your project gets derailed for any reason, say, for example, some health reasons. So yes to planning, but I'm open to pantsterism. I know it does help some people. So there you have it. There's some quick and easy writing advice with William Bernhardt on his writing podcast. So to recap, we talked about my number one tip, which was to set a deadline. Some ideas for starting life story projects. This is the planning. You need to do a little bit of planning. And then the third one, are you a planner or are you a pantster? And I think we know the answer to that one. Definitely a planner. But I hope you will go and listen, and you can also watch this podcast episode. You can go to my website, foreveryoungautobiographies.com/redsneakerwriters. I have more details on the answers to the questions that William asked me, some links to some other helpful articles, and there's links there to his website where you can watch or listen to the podcast. So please go check it out. While you're at the website or while you're here with me now, I'd love for you to leave me a comment. Answer this question. Are you a planner or are you a pantster? Let's see what the general consensus is out there. And if you have any questions about life story writing, you can go to my website and send me an email from foreveryoungautobiographies.com/contact. So earlier at the start of the show, I mentioned the Structure Success video training. This is where I walk you through some key exercises, and we come up with that rough outline. We think about the key events, the key memories, and we put them all in a bit of a logical order so that you can then get your writing started in a really good fashion. Now, to get this training, go to foreveryoungautobiographies.com/structure-success, sign up. I'll have all the links to everything in the show notes, so please look out for that. Now, I'll be back again soon with another topic. So until then, happy writing.